What are you doing out here?
Oh, I'm just thinking.
Ooh. Thanks, man. This means a lot to me.
Hey, guys.
Oh.
Cocktail, anyone?
You dog.
So this has got to be weird for you, Danny.
We, better get back inside.
Yeah. Just give me a minute.
Dan, I'm sorry it didn't work out with Pamela.
I'm over it.
Still.
Hey, you heard the man. He's over it. Hold on to that.
All right.
I'm gonna go in.
I'm really happy for you, Carl.
Thanks, man. Come get you when they're ready. All right?
Yeah. All right.
This is where all the champagne went.
No, this is where all the champagne's going.
Do you mind if I sit down?
Sure.
Hi.
Hi.
It's Danny Sorensen, right?
How would you know that?
I know your sister.
Really? I've never seen you with Dana.
Smile for the picture. I take it you don't like weddings very much.
What, I don't look like I'm having a good time?
Well, it's just that you're the best man, and you haven't even danced yet. You still miss her, don't you?
Who? I don't know what you're talking about.
Pamela.
Pamela. Pamela Richardson?
You know, that's weird to hear you say Richardson. Her name is Heard now.
Oh, that's right, Heard. Miranda Turd.
I met her through an acquaintance.
My sister?
You know what? I don't even think she remembers me.
But you still got an invitation.
Well, no, I'm actually not invited. I just like going to weddings. I guess you could call me a wedding crusher. I don't know. If I read about one or hear about one in the paper, I just like to show up and watch. I try to go to one every week. I don't normally stay for the reception, though, just the ceremony.
But you stayed this time.
I hate this gig. Schlepping drinks for these rich frat boys, $6 an hour plus tips.
Hey, Mr. Sorensen! Whoa! Hey! My main man, huh? My main man. What's your name?
Freddie, what's yours?
Irrelevant. Listen, Freddie, I'm thinking you're jerking me around on the vodka. Last drink I had tasted like a soda pop. Listen, this time around, how about a lot less Collins and a whole lot more vodka? You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, you do. Oh, whoa. Hey now. Now we're understanding each other. Thank you very much, Teddy.
Ready.
Again, irrelevant. Listen, I forgot my wallet at home, but I'll catch you next time. Let's go now, boy.
So is Pam still in New York?
Yeah, modeling's finally paying her bills.
Yeah, right. Her husband's paying the bills. Modeling was always her excuse to hate her job.
Mm-hmm. Do you want any help with that?
No, I got it.
You're definitely not over her, are you?
What?
Well, beautiful girl comes and sits at your table and asks you if you'd like to dance. You're more interested in what your ex-girlfriend is doing in New York than what this girl's name might be.
Sorry. So what is your name?
Jojo.
But you brought her up, Jojo.
Yeah, but she was already on your mind.
Who are you? And what is this?
I know what happened between you and Pamela. I know that she left you the day before the wedding. I need to tell you something, Danny. It's something that you should know.
I'm listening.
Pamela and Carl were seeing each other the whole time that you guys were a couple. And even on the day she broke up with you, she just left his place before she came over to yours.
And how do you know this?
I just do, okay?
That's impossible. Carl and Dana were together long before I even knew Pam.
I know.
That doesn't prove anything.
Did you take that picture? It's a bar in New York. You've never even been to New York.
How would you know that?
Have you? Look, I'm sorry.
Thanks.
Turn.
see. I've known Carl since we were 18. We rushed the same fraternity. Go Pikes. Yeah, then we went to law school. We had a lot of good times. Heck, you'd think we'd have dated the same girls. But Carl and I obeyed the unwritten rule between friends, didn't we, Carl? What is a friend? Better yet, what is a best man? The best man is the person the groom chooses to be by his side during probably the most important moment of his life. The moment when a man decides to commit to someone forever. And that someone is my little sister, who I love more than anyone in the world. So be accountable. Don't let us down.
I won't, buddy.
So, as your best man, I propose a toast to Carl and his beautiful wife, Dana. May you live happily ever after.
What was that all about?
Just a little extra for good luck.
The best man.
City for the first time.
Nice.
So you left without saying goodbye?
Well, I did what I came to do.
You sure did.
Did you tell anyone?
No. I'm cursed with this information.
So what are you gonna do?
I'm gonna drink this shot.
Have you been here by yourself all night?
Yeah.
Do you know how to two-step? Do you want me to show you?
Sure.
To the world. For the last couple of years, this front has not been a very accurate reflection of your inner depths. Too often, and sometimes with good cause, you've hesitated to unveil the totality of who you really are. I predict that this will change this year, however. More and more, you'll have a knack for getting your persona to express the surprising truths about your unique and ever-churning soul. And it all starts in earnest now.
What was that?
That was your horoscope, Danny. You're not even listening to me.
How'd you know I was a Libra?
Lucky guess.
What?
It's a wedding to go to!
All right, I forgot you're a big wedding crasher.
It's my favorite pastime.
And why is that? I mean, I can't imagine going to see two people that I don't even know get married. I can barely sit through them as it is.
Yeah, well, maybe you're watching the wrong things.
I mean, do you at least heckle them? You making animal sounds during the vows, that kind of thing? And that would be fun.
No. No, the vows are the best part. To honor and to love for the rest of your life. That's powerful. By the way, you're coming with me.
No, that's all right.
Oh, that's really, really nice. I let you stay at my house. I let you sleep on my couch. I let you have my favorite pillow. I even cook you flapjacks. And you can't even do this one thing for me.
Did you notice anything unusual?
No, I don't.
Look around. What do you see?
I see people at a wedding.
Right, Jojo, I don't feel, I feel weird here. I feel like I stick out like a sore thumb.
Turn around. Go on. No, you look fine. The cowboy boots are great. Come on. Hi.
Are you here for the bride or the groom?
Both.
You two are white.
We're going.
Yes, we are, but the wedding's about to start, so we have to be quiet now, okay? Don't you? Weird. Everything is weird for you.
You have another word for it?
How about different? Oh, she's beautiful. Look, isn't she beautiful?
She is.
Watching a wedding is like watching a sunrise. It's a new beginning, Danny. Just watch and listen. It's magical. It really is. Oh, this is gonna be a wonderful wedding. It really is. Yeah, that was a good wedding. They're gonna make it, I can tell.
How do you know?
Oh,
I could just see it in their eyes, Danny.
No, I mean, how will I know? If and when I find the right girl, and I emphasize the word if, how will I know that what I'm seeing is what I'm getting?
Yeah, well, if we had the answers to everything, life wouldn't be exciting, would it? It's not knowing that makes you want to get out of bed in the morning. So don't take that for granted. I mean, imagine if it was the opposite and you knew everything that was ever going to happen. Well, then your life would just be boring, wouldn't it?
You think you'd be married by now?
Noah, I'll never be married.
You don't want to get married?
I didn't say I didn't want to get married.
Or you never will?
Yeah, I'll never be married.
So you go to weddings, you recite the vows to yourself, but you don't ever want to say them to somebody? You're weird.
It's complicated. Hey, stand up.
What are you doing?
Okay, now. You're LeVar, and I'm Betty, and we want to get married.
Who are you trying to sound like?
We're from Arkansas, Danny.
So, we're cousins?
Come on, play along now. Now, do you, LeVar, take this lovely lady, Betty, to be your lawfully wedded wife? If so, say I do. Well, come on now, it's easy. I do. Just say it.
I do.
All right, now say it like you mean it.
I do.
Uh-huh. Now, do you, Betty, take this lovely young man to be your lawfully wedded husband? If so, say I do.
I do.
Okay, so here's the best part, LeVar. You gotta promise.
Okay, this is ridiculous.
Promise to love and to cherish, to honor and protect in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for the rest of your life, so help you God.
I do.
Okay, then. Betty. Do you promise to love and to cherish, to honor and protect in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for the rest of your life? So help you God. I do.
And by the powers vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Hey, we're cousins, remember?
Did you ever wish on a shooting star?
No, I don't believe in all that.
Really? You believe in angels?
Yeah, I believe in angels. Especially when I'm sitting next to one.
Has anyone ever fallen for that?
All the time. What? How about you? Do you believe in them?
Yeah. They say that every time a star falls from heaven, that an angel is sent to Earth to guide somebody's life.
Oh, is that what they say? Well, I'm sure that's true.
All right, smarty, then how do you explain them?
I can't explain them, but I can't explain bald men with ponytails either. I think there's some things I'm just not meant to understand.
Sometimes it's not the things that you can see or touch that are real. Sometimes it's what you feel in your heart that's most tangible. ancient philosophers believed that there was a language that was spoken by angels and it couldn't be translated or repeated because it was only understood by the soul.
Ancient philosophers also believed the world was flat.
All right, I give up.
Six days, I've been a slave. I need a break, a beer. I'm getting out of here, thank God. This week is finally through. My buddy's got a head start. I know right where they are. Gotta get them moving. That's getting up to do. I got a 40-hour weekend. Ain't no time for sleeping.
You okay? What's wrong?
I'm just feeling a little lightheaded. Look, I need to talk to you about us.
About us? Okay.
There's a reason why I don't date.
What do you mean?
I can't date.
I'm too late.
What I said to you before is true. There's no point to this. I don't date because I'm not destined to be married.
We're just dancing and having a good time. Believe me, marriage is the farthest thing from my mind, too.
I don't want to get any closer to you. There's no future for us.
Let's cross that bridge when we get to it.
We're at it. We can't see you anymore.
Wait a second. Why? Why?
Excuse me.
Where are you going?
I have to go.
You're just gonna leave without saying goodbye?
Yes, because I knew you would do this.
Do what?
Try and stop me.
See you around.
No, don't be like this.
Be like what? What do you want me to do? You want me to cry? Is this a game? I'm through with that.
One day you'll understand me, Danny.
Where? On my deathbed?
Please just let me go.
Go?
Don't hate me.
Don't hate you? Don't hate you? I don't hate you. I'll just never understand you. I mean, out of the blue, you just decide that you don't want to see me anymore? Why does sudden indecisiveness just target the girls that I fall in love with? You want me to say it again? You do, right? You want me to say it again? I love you. I love you. Because I'm an idiot.
Not one for you, Daddy.
Spare me. Spare me. Your meter's running.
He kissed the teardrops from her face. Turned and headed for the door. And in his eyes she caught a trace of all the tears he cried before. She whispered softly, please don't leave me. It was all she could do. But the teardrops kept on falling. She knew this time he was true.
Hi. I'm really sorry to bother you. Do you have any cables?
No, sorry. I don't.
No? Okay. Are you okay? Do you want me to call you a taxi or... I don't know, maybe you wanna... catch a ride with us?
No, I have a taxi. It's coming.
Oh, okay. Okay, we'll see you later.
Bye. Hey. Good luck with the battery. This is...
Thank you.
Present for helping you boost your car.
It's Benny. I'm kidding. It's Benny.
So, hey, you girls want to drink some beer?
No.
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 Battery?
Can you wait a second here?
Sure. But the meter starts now.
Stop
well,
it.
Girl, don't jumpstart that car, then, huh?
I might need your help, man.
What?
Well, there's four of them and there's only one of me. I don't think I'm gonna be able to do this by myself.
Hey, Amy, let's go.
Thanks a lot, you guys.
Thank you. Hey, let her go, let her go, let her go, let her go, let her go. It's cool, let her go.
Thank you very, very much for helping us out.
I mean, you can go over there and play with your old cowboy friends, but the cab leaves, okay? I mean, they don't pay me enough for that.
All right, tell you what. We'll skip the drinking. We'll jump straight to the,
Don't stop right now. I have mace in my purse.
Okay.
I have mace.
You have mace?
What's it gonna be?
Go get him, Tex.
Hey, don't touch her, man.
Hey,
this is
bad. You got a problem here?
Okay,
get rid of that guy.
Okay, we're problems. So why don't you step along, okay?
So you're saying there's no problem here?
Look, like I said, cowgirl, ain't a problem, right? Okay.
Why don't you leave these girls alone? Can't you see they're obviously being scared by you?
Yeah, no, he's right. Yeah, let the girls go. Let them go. Bye, girls.
Let the cars fixed.
Give the girl her mace.
So
who puts you in charge of canceling the party, cowboy?
Nobody, I'm just telling...
What? Huh? No. You know what, I think me and you, we ought to have a little chat, because I've had about enough of you, man. You know what I'm saying?
No, 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 no,
Betty. Get some. Get some, Betty.
He's alive.
What, was I in a coma?
No, the doctor said that you should probably, you would be waking up soon. This is my boyfriend, Blaine, and this is Danny.
How you feeling?
Oh, be careful. The doctor said that you might have bruised your ribs.
Go ahead and confirm it.
Are you in a lot of pain?
Of course he's in pain, come on.
Do you remember what happened?
I have a clue.
You pretty much saved me and my sister's life last night.
I saved your life?
She tends to be a little bit dramatic.
The way I remember it, I walked over and three guys beat me up.
No, it was four.
Yeah, right.
You're gonna have to stay here overnight, but I totally don't mind, you know, just staying here and hanging out. I just have to call the dude ranch.
Candice, probably just need some sleep or something, right? I mean,
yeah, sure. Listen, thank you for staying. And thank you for the flowers. I really appreciate it. You've been really sweet.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Hi. How are you feeling this morning?
Excuse me.
Hey, cowboy.
Do you know what happened to the girl that lived in this apartment?
She moved out.
When?
Yesterday.
So how you doing?
I'm good. Keeping real busy, getting the house organized.
And how's everything with Carl?
Oh, we're good.
Everything's okay?
Yeah. You know, I've never been happier.
You sure you don't want a beer?
No. I can't.
Why?
Because I'm pregnant.
What?
I said I'm pregnant, Danny. We found out a week ago. Come on, aren't you excited? You're gonna be an uncle.
Yeah, congratulations. Oh, man.
Just a second.
How's this? Okay?
Hey, buddy. We were just going over my comments on the Milansky agreement.
Danny.
Hi, Sherry.
So, what's going on?
I'm just dropping these off, the preliminaries you asked for.
Great, we're expecting them.
Okay,
thanks. Sure, we'll finish this up later, right? Sure.
Okay. Danny?
Yeah, these look okay.
So, why do you have to lock the door to look over a contract?
Didn't even know it was locked. What? Oh, come on. Danny, give me a little credit, all right? Sherry?
You know, Carl, being your friend doesn't mean you can hand me the turn the other way pass every time there's something you don't want me to see.
Danny, what are you talking about? We're marking up a contract. I mean, I can't believe you'd think anything else. I wouldn't touch her with a 9-iron.
No?
No.
What about Pamela? Would you touch her?
What? What, your Pamela?
Yeah, right. My Pamela. Look what I've got here.
Listen, Dan,
you know, what you did to me is fine. But Dana doesn't deserve it.
Nothing was happening, Danny.
Yeah, well, you obviously think I'm some kind of schmuck. But I know what I'd find tucked between those cushions.
You gonna tell her?
I gotta tell her. No, no apology, no explanation. Just worried about yourself, right? I don't know what I'm gonna do, Carl. You sweat it out. But you can tell your father, thanks for the opportunity. But this isn't for me.
Excuse the mess, it's still a work in progress. So I just have a few more stretches to do outside. You want something to drink? I have water, beer, wine.
No, I'm all right.
Okay.
Wow, this is nice.
Yeah, it just got here yesterday. It was handmade in Japan. Donna had one at her house. As soon as I saw it, I fell in love with it. I knew I had to have one of my own.
So how's the pregnancy coming?
As you can see, it's coming. But I refuse to let myself get fat.
Oh.
What are you doing? Aren't you supposed to be at work?
Yeah. I wanted to talk to you about something. I don't know if I should do this, Dana.
Do what?
Do you know why Pamela and I didn't work out? I mean, I know you probably have some idea, but do you know the real reason?
Yeah, I do.
You do?
Yeah. I said I do. I know why.
You mean you know that she was seeing someone else?
Yes. I know who she was seeing. What, you just found out?
No, I found out at your wedding.
You want to... a beer?
No, let me just make sure that I'm clear about this. You're telling me that you're all right with it?
No, I'm telling you, I don't need you to be my big brother all the time. I'm a big girl now, Danny. I can take care of myself, make my own decisions and judgments.
You know it wasn't just Pam, right? You know there were other girls.
I know. Danny, I know a lot more than you think I know.
And I'm fine, okay? I'm fine. You sure you don't want a beer?
Yeah, okay. Give me a beer. I quit the firm today.
Hope not because of me.
No, it wasn't because of you.
Why then?
Because I can't live like that. I'd rather just not do it.
Well?
Well?
Well, do what you gotta do, Danny.
It's an amazing view. It's really amazing. You know, when I was driving over here, I didn't realize that you'd gotten everything that you wanted. I'm a poor judge of character, and that's my problem. Yeah. You see, I mistook you for somebody who wanted more than a nice view out of life.
Danny, what do you want me to say?
You've already said it, loud and clear.
You know, sometimes it's easier to see what you want to see.
How is that easier, Dana?
You tell me. How did you not know about Pam? I mean, the girl would flirt with every guy who pay any attention to her.
I don't need to hear this.
Of course you don't, because then you'd have to admit to how naive that is.
Yeah, well, at least I didn't sell out.
How dare you come over here waving a banner of truth in my face?
I'm not waving anything in your face. You're my sister, and I care about you, and I thought you should know.
No, this visit is not about me. It's about you wanting company to your pity party, Danny.
Dana, your husband is cheating on you all over town. Don't you care about that?
If I choose to compromise a little here and a little there...
That's not a compromise. You've given up.
I'm living my life. You know, not everyone can be like you, Danny. Daydreaming through life, waiting for some perfect love to come whistling down from heaven. I mean, some people are not that hopeful. So go ahead and just judge me. It's fine, I don't care.
Find one you like.
Danny, hi.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I've been all right. So who's the lucky guy?
Oh, I'm not actually giving one out this year. I just like reading the cards, you know.
What happened to what's his name?
Blaine. He got a job offer in Cleveland, and I think he's already met somebody else. So. You know, I heard they were engaged now, actually. I mean, like, I care.
you aiming?
Yeah.
At the bottles, right? It's just you need to line the target.
Where else would I be aiming?
At the bottles.
Okay.
What'd you say?
I didn't say anything.
That's weird. I thought you said, oh, poops.
How silly. I would never say that.
Hmm. Okay, well, listen. Keep this arm straight.
Okay.
Line it up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
You might want to hold your breath.
I had a really good time today. I'll just see you when I see you, I guess.
Candice.
Yeah?
If you're not doing anything later, maybe we should hang out.
Oh, really?
I can cook you dinner in my apartment in the city.
Okay. I mean, that's fine. I'm gonna go home and change.
No, come on in.
Because I think I'm a bit overdressed.
No, not at all. Come on in. Here, let me take your coat.
Okay, great. I'll just put my purse.
Okay. You look great.
Thanks.
You're not upset, are you?
No.
Because I think you look wonderful.
Thank you.
Really?
No, it's fine.
Okay. Here, wait one second. Okay. Just, make yourself at home.
Okay.
And I'll be right back. We could go out to dinner.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Better?
I would love that.
Okay.
Great. I love that.
Good. I could.
It's fine.
Yeah?
Yeah, totally.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, then maybe we.
Okay.
Okay, good.
Good. I gotta ask you this. Who is this girl on all these pictures on your wall?
Oh, that would be Pamela.
Oh, the model who dumped you, like, the day before your wedding?
Correct. Painfully blunt, but correct.
So when are you gonna take these pictures off your wall?
I just haven't gotten around to it yet.
And then you meet this girl at this wedding who just, like, mysteriously disappears, so she basically dumped you too?
Wow, you really get right to the point.
Oh, no, no, no. What I'm saying is that I understand why you're bitter or angry about love. Because basically you've been dumped by two girls in 2 years, and if that were me, I would be bitter too.
Well, thank you for the support.
Oh, don't.
Buy you coffee. So you're still looking for Mr. Wright?
Yes. I am still looking for the one.
The one?
Yeah, well, I believe that when the time is right, the one that, you know, I'm supposed to marry or whatever is gonna come into my life, you know.
So you believe that there's only one person out there for you?
Yeah.
Well, what if he lives in Russia or someplace? I mean, you never cross paths.
I definitely don't believe that. If he's the one, then we will definitely cross paths.
Maybe I'm the one.
No way. No, I mean, you only date like these, I don't know, like these supermodel types.
So? Well, seriously, how are you going to know when you find the right one?
I don't know, because I'm gonna feel it inside.
What are you gonna feel?
I haven't felt it before. All right?
Not even with Blaine?
No, not even with Blaine. Of course not.
I think I felt it before.
Oh, yeah? With Pamela?
No, with the other one who dumped me.
Oh.
No, seriously, I think I felt that before.
Can you describe it?
I can't put it into words.
Oops.
What did you say? You said it again.
Shh.
You said it. You did say it. You said it again. Hey. You said poops.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. I heard you say it.
I'm so embarrassed. I feel so dumb. Okay, I'm not going to say it again.
I like it.
No.
I like it. I think it's cute.
I had a lot of fun tonight.
Me too.
Yeah? Hey, listen. Why don't you come and work with me at the Dude Ranch until something else pans out?
What would I do?
Be yourself. I mean, the kids would love to have a true cowboy.
Yeah, I'm not a real cowboy.
No, I know you're not a real cowboy. They would know the difference. And we can pay you. It's not going to be like a lawyer's salary, but we can pay you something.
It isn't about the money. I'm just, are you sure?
Yeah. Most definitely. You can start on Monday.
This isn't a pity offer.
Yeah, it is, but I think you should get over yourself.
This is my sister, Jane.
Howdy.
Hi, Jane. Nice to meet you.
Come on, yeah. I'll show you around.
All right.
So is it true? Three guys kicked the living daylights out of you at the Westerner?
Well, actually, it was four.
Well, that was pretty brave of you to take a licking like that for my sisters.
Yeah.
And this is Joelle and Matthias.
Hi.
What's up?
And you know Amy.
Hi, Dan.
Hi.
Howdy.
The good-looking one is Amy's boyfriend, Travis.
Huh?
The other one is my husband, Steve.
Oh.
Okay, now, see you guys. Tell me who wants to go on a horse next. Who is afraid of horses? You are? Okay, so you're next. You're going to go on the horse. Do you know that I used to be very, very, very scared of horses when I was a little kid? Working hard?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, don't worry, you're not going to be doing this for too much longer. Maybe soon you can
come out with me and the kids.
Oh, yeah? Listen, this isn't work. I love being outdoors.
Good. Well, I was, just checking up on you. Come on.
Hey, thanks for this.
See ya. Would you like to dance?
Yeah.
Okay.
That guy's been after you all night.
I couldn't keep him off of me, but I think I finally got him off my trail.
Huh. What'd you say?
I said that you were my boyfriend.
Really?
Uh-huh. And that you were getting ready to kick his butt.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Well, maybe we should do something to convince him.
What do you mean?
I mean, maybe we should do something to really convince him that I'm your boyfriend.
And how do you propose we do that?
Do you think he's watching?
I think we should do it again, just to be sure. I just want to know how you feel about tonight.
What do you mean?
Well, I don't know what I mean. I just want to know how you feel.
I feel good.
You promise?
Yeah, I promise.
Look, Danny, I don't want to get hurt again. You know, and if tonight was a mistake, it's cool. I just want you to tell me.
It wasn't a mistake.
You know, you mean a lot to me. Even before tonight happened.
You make me feel amazing. I wanted to kiss you for a long time now.
Really? Oh, wow. I'm really sorry about calling so late. I've just been going through all these emotions lately.
It's all right. I like listening to your voice. I took the pictures down.
Really?
Like, really? Yeah.
Me and my sister just loved fairy tales, so we fight in the backseat of our station wagon. My dad
would turn around and say, if you're not good girls, your knight in shining armor won't come one day.
I bet it worked.
Yep, every time.
Oh, Candice, have you looked outside? The sun's about to come up.
Yeah, I know. I've been standing out here all night. I'm actually watching the sun come up over the mountains now.
You're outside?
Yeah.
I didn't hear you go outside.
Yeah. Hey, can you get up on your roof?
Yeah.
Why don't you go up there and watch the sunrise?
Oh. Okay, all right.
Danny?
Watching a wedding is like watching a sunrise.
Danny?
Yeah, I'm here.
It's a new beginning, Danny. Just watch and listen, it's magical. It really is.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, Dad.
Oh, okay, you first. Okay.
You can hold him. No. Yeah.
Good. Yeah. Oh, I've got you. And there goes your hat. Oh, you're beautiful. He's beautiful. Oh, look at him.
Hi. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, look at that nose.
So, Dad, how's it feel to be Grandpa?
It's nice.
Oh, my
thank you for coming to this most festive occasion. You may be seated. I've written a passage that I'd like to share with you today. As the rays of the sun warm us on this most beautiful day, we stand here on a carpet of soft grass, and the scents tantalize our noses from the beautiful bouquets of flowers while the songbirds serenade us.
Hi.
Hi.
You have amazing timing.
Yeah, I've been told that before.
I thought I'd never see you again. Where did you go?
Jojo? I can't believe it. Give me a hug. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I can't believe you made it.
Well, I couldn't miss Amy's wedding.
This is my boyfriend, Danny.
Yeah, we already know each
other. Oh, you guys have met.
Yeah, we met a while ago.
I can't believe you're here. I'm so excited. We have so much to get caught up on.
I know.
There's been so many come and go. If this one's real, well, it's hard to know. My walls are up, built up and strong. Are you the one to prove me wrong? I wanna believe you, I wanna get close. I'm warning you now, I'm playing slow.
Well, they look so perfect together. Do you think they're gonna make it?
I think they're gonna be fine.
You always had a knack for that kind of thing. Do you remember how you predicted that Blaine and I wouldn't work out? You were totally right. He was
yeah.
Such a jerk.
Well, that was obvious, huh?
So how do you two know each other?
Jojo used to work with me at the ranch.
Yeah. I still miss the kids.
Oh, you gotta come back.
No.
No, seriously, they miss you so much.
Yeah. Well, I'm kind of getting situated at the moment.
Danny works with me at the ranch now.
Really?
Yeah.
Last time I saw you, you were a lawyer.
Yeah, well, last time I saw you, I was a lot of things. So you went out of town for a while, huh?
Mm-hmm. I had some family business to attend to.
Big family?
Pretty big.
How did you two meet?
I met Jojo at a wedding.
Ah.
Jojo's the girl who told me about Pamela.
So, she's the girl who... It's a small world.
Well, it's a nice wedding. It's a beautiful wedding.
Yes. Yeah.
It's really beautiful. Can I come in?
So where's Candice? I thought she was with you.
She just dropped me off.
Why didn't she come up?
She had to go to her sister's.
So what's up?
Well, I wanted her to come to a wedding with me, and she couldn't, so I was wondering if maybe you would.
Just like old times, huh?
I just wanted you to know that I'm sorry, and I realize that I let things go too far.
So spending time with somebody is suddenly reckless behavior?
Well, it all turned out for the best.
Yeah?
Excuse me, man.
Yeah, sorry, brother. I'm looking for my... Oh.
Hey, what are you afraid of? She's right here. And she loves you.
What's going on?
She's being a real big baby, and... He doesn't want to get married.
She wants to spend the rest of her life with you.
How do you know that?
I can hear it in your voice how much she loves you.
You want a beer?
No.
Hey. Ancient philosophers believed that there was a language that was spoken by angels and it couldn't be translated or repeated because it was only understood by the soul.
Thank you. Baby, I love you.
You know him?
tough.
Yeah.
Candice is the one for you, Danny.
You know, Candice believes there's only one person out of all the billions of people out there for her.
What do you believe?
I believe you could marry several people and end up with one.
So maybe that one is the one that you're destined to be with and the others are just decoys.
Is that what you are, JoJo? Decoy?
What are you doing?
I don't know.
I followed you today. I mean, I felt like I was in eighth grade all over again. I mean, my heart and my mind have just been racing. And, you know, I kind of feel like I interrupted something.
Well, you didn't.
Are you sure about that, Danny?
Look. If you're gonna be jealous when I'm alone with JoJo, just say so and I won't do it. You shouldn't have dropped her off at my house to begin with.
Why? Should I be jealous?
Of course not.
Because you're my boyfriend. And she's one of my closest friends. And if I were to be jealous of you, it would mean that I don't trust you. And that if I don't trust you, then we shouldn't be together.
Where is this coming from?
This is important to me. This is not some trivial fling where if it doesn't work out, I'm going to move on to the next guy. I am not Pamela. What you see is what you get, and if that's not good enough for you, I want you to tell me now.
You're enough. Of course you're enough.
Danny, when we first met, you were so honest with me. So honest that sometimes it really, really hurt. Okay, but at least I knew where I stood with you.
You know where you stand with me. I love you.
Do you still love her?
Who do you love?
I came here to say goodbye.
Just like that?
Just like that.
So where are you going?
I have to go.
I want to go with you.
See for days. Why are you being so quiet?
think it's a mistake, don't you?
Well, it's not me that's got something to lose, is it? What? What is it?
Nothing.
I love you. I think I'm gonna need to pull off at the next gas station. I'm feeling kind of sick.
Grocery store, right?
That's correct. But I was laid off. It's 11:50.
Danny.
What the? Who put that on the TV?
I don't know, I think it's NBC.
It's 11:50, man.
Come on. What? That's me. And that's Candace.
Yeah, yeah, whatever you say, movie star. Mind?
Oh, yeah, sorry. Oh, sorry.
Oh, poops.
You didn't say that. Say it again.
Oh, poops. And, a bad habit. Sounds kind of gay.
That is like the cutest thing you could say. That's what Candace used to say. Oh, poops. How cute is that?
It's very cute. Now, are you on drugs or what?
And there's some really strange things happening to me today.
Really? There you go, buddy. There you go. Have a nice trip. Next!
Not one for you, Daddy.
I'm with the wrong girl.
What, you mean her?
Somewhere that's not letting enough oxygen get to your heart. We're going to have to do something. I hear what's happening.
She haven't really told me anything.
Okay. These people have been staying there for quite a while. We did actually.
Dr. Stern.
What's happening?
Oh, you have a very sick young girl here. Do you know anything about it, either of you?
Is she gonna be okay?
Well, we don't know. We have to run a series of tests to find out.
Can you talk to her?
Well, yes, but you have to be very short.
Thanks.
Hi. Why didn't you tell me anything?
That's it, staff. Clear the room, stat. I must resuscitate.
She's coding!
I'm sorry. Your friend has passed away.
What did she say to you?
I don't know. I didn't understand her. But whatever she said calmed me. And made me feel like everything is gonna be okay.
There's another one night. I was lying on the ground, and I saw a star dart across the sky, and I made a wish. For the first time in my life, I made a wish. I know that sounds silly, but I did it. I wished for something real, something true to come into my life, and I promised that if it did, I would never let it go. And when I opened my eyes, I saw the most beautiful girl standing over me. And she said, "Excuse me, do you have any cables? Can you ever forgive me?" I want to be your knight in shining armor.
You are Danny. I knew that you were from the very first moment I met you.
You did?
Yeah. I just felt it. I just didn't want to jinx it. But you're the one. You're definitely the one.
Thank you.
see.
Jojo.
You don't recognize me.
I'm dreaming, right?
I don't know. Are you?
What's going on?
I saw your wedding today. It was beautiful.
I'm talking to my imagination, right? Are you an angel?
No, you don't believe in angels.
I'm starting to.
Maybe there's a reason why we met. Maybe there's more plan and less coincidence involved in your life.
It doesn't make any sense. I mean, I fell in love with you.
Well, nobody said angels were perfect.
So you're telling me that you're an angel sent down for me? I don't deserve an angel.
Danny, you're so beautiful, but sometimes you just don't think. I wasn't sent here for you.
Danny? What are you doing?
I was talking.
Hey, honey, who were you talking to? Danny, are you okay? Danny?
I was wishing I could thank the angels that led me to you.
Come here. They're waiting for us to start the first dance. I love you.
You okay?
Yeah.
It's a tough job, but somebody's got to do it, huh? So where to now, boss?
You ever been to Vegas?